Hi, I'm Philippa Thomas, Managing Director and co-founder of Thomas Thomas Films with Kevin Thomas, the director. Thomas Thomas has been established for 20 years now, and we've won all sorts of awards, BTAs, Cannes Lions, DNADs. In 2004, Kev won an Emmy for Most Outstanding TV Campaign of the Year, and his short film True Love Once Removed was shortlisted for Oscar nomination. I also produce for Isaac Julian, the Turner-nominated installation artist. The piece I produced was called True Love, and it premiered at the Pompidou Centre in Paris. Most recently, I'm co-founder of the Wayback, a virtual reality film series designed to help people who are living with dementia. The Wayback is creativity meeting technology for good. By marrying together creativity, cutting-edge technology, and personal experience, we've created a tool for people living with dementia, a tool that enables them and helps with their well-being. It was born from a very personal gut instinct, and the creative inspiration came from a team we work with a lot in advertising, creative directors Dan Cole and Andy Garnett.
The Wayback came about largely as a result of my personal experience with my dad when he was diagnosed with Alzheimer's. Although it was very hard to spot at the beginning, gradually it became more difficult to hold a conversation with dad. However, reminiscing about certain things, music, sport, his younger life did help. One afternoon, I remember, I drove him back to the town where he grew up, and I found that almost immediately, when he was immersed in familiar sights and sounds, dad began to talk and joke about memories from his younger days. The conversation flowed much easier and Dad seemed happy. It was a day I never forgot. Sadly, Dad died not long after that trip down memory lane. But later, as I read more about the disease, it became clear that for people living with Alzheimer's, the past is such a strong source of comfort. Chatting with friends who had been through similar experiences, we began to wonder if there was a way to immerse those living with Alzheimer's in happy snapshots from their own past. And we wondered if friends and family could use the memories that it might prompt to help connect with their loved one and help make the most of every moment they have left with them. Through research in existing reminiscence therapy, we began to learn about the use of vintage props, music, film and pictures, therapy that had been going on for a long time. But we believed that new technology and perhaps an immersive virtual reality experience could be a valuable addition. And so the idea for the Wayback was born. An innovative way to support people with Alzheimer's using 360-degree virtual reality. We believe that we could create a deeply personal experience through attention to creativity, simple, accessible technology, and a person-first approach.
This next topic is a serious one, but we hope you'll find it uplifting too. There's a project designed to help people with dementia to relive lost memories using immersive video.
A virtual reality reenactment of life in 1953, using modern technology to go back in time in the hope that it triggers a distant memory.
They suddenly feel that they're there and they can understand where they are, and they can understand the time and day.
Or by actually watching a Wayback film, you can be there in a second, that feeling of, wow, I lived this, I was there, I wore that dress.
Oh yeah, oh my God, yay!
The Wayback is a series of virtual reality films to help people living with dementia relive moments from their past and to really feel the happy emotions connected with them. In the pilot episode, viewers are transported back to a Queen's Coronation Street party, just like the thousands that took place across Britain in the summer of 1953. Filmmakers faithfully recreated the day in stunning 360 degrees with immersive detail, painstakingly accurate from the fashion to the food, right down to the conversations.
Very good.
It's amazing.
That was absolutely marvellous.
Are you a princess?
Hello.
It's good to be a smile.
Yeah, I'm the boy. Yeah, I'm
great. He's in the Navy. Chasing the girls about.
Well, it's not very often you can go into the past like that, is it?
There's a lot of happy memories there.
The feeling of being back in the old times.
I think that's fabulous what you're doing.
Makes me feel good. But weepy.
It is a
There's a canoodling going on there.
This film and the rest in the series will bring back feelings from a moment in time and will trigger more happy memories for people living with dementia, creating more meaningful conversations and connections with their loved ones and carers.
They were taken somewhere very different, and it obviously brought up really good memories, and obviously from then we just started reminiscing and talking and sharing stories, and we rambled on forever, well after we put these things down.
It's marvellous. Absolutely marvellous.
Every time I hear a newborn baby cry, or touch a leaf, or see the sky, then I know why I believe.
My lovely voice.
Thank you. I've always liked singing.
With no experience other than our own in caring for people with dementia, we had to ask for some expert help. Dr. David Sheard from Dementia Care Matters gave us the reassurance and the inspiration to just go for it. So rather than approaching charities who have their own focus and their own issues, we decided to go it alone and make a pilot film. We raised the funds on Kickstarter and had 260 backers worldwide, and we reached our target of £35,000 with literally minutes to spare. So the pilot film was shot on location in London with 150 volunteer cast, and we recreated the Queen's coronation of 1953. But we didn't recreate the coronation itself, but one of the many street parties that were happening up and down the country that millions of people were enjoying on that day. We created a scene where the neighbours were sitting in someone's living room watching one of the first televisions. All the footage of the news on the television, the food, the wardrobe, the music, all recreated in complete authentic detail. We don't use computer graphics in the making of The Wayback. Instead, we recreate in painstaking detail millions of memory triggers in each episode. So this makes it a very person-centred experience, a person-centred reminiscence experience. So instead of there being one or two memory triggers, like a photograph, a piece of music, there are literally hundreds of memory triggers in every episode. This enables people to relive their past and those memories in order to create memories now and conversations in the present. The film Kevin directed shows how important it is to have authenticity and detail in immersive storytelling, and how creativity and narrative can work alongside cutting-edge technology.
The research for the actual film started long before the cameras rolled, beginning with visits to care homes that had a mix of elderly residents and those living with dementia. We recorded the residents' personal recollections, which uncovered priceless details, such as their recollections of the Queen of Tonga riding in an open-top coach during the procession after the coronation, winning the hearts of the British public in the rain. And it was a memory that would become an overheard conversation in our film.
The not waltzes, that was all right. That was the last thing. The last waltz was the big thing. That's who was going to take you home.
I used to go to town, barking. Yeah, Stratford.
Plenty of pillion riding and going round the corner, you know, leaning over. You know, brr, brr.
All of the food and drink on the table in the film also came from our memory sessions with the residents. There were happy recollections of fish paste sandwiches, jelly and ice cream, pilchers and Mackeson's stout. Another lady even sang us a selection of skipping songs, and these too can be seen in the final film. The details that we uncovered also provided a rich choice for our wardrobe and prop departments as we set about obtaining objects such as commemorative spoons and cups that were given out on the day. The Wayback was born from a creative instinct to address a need that we felt wasn't being met. Our pilot film, the 1953 Queen's Coronation, showed how immersive storytelling is at its best when used to get an emotional reaction and address a direct need. The world of dementia care sat up and took notice. Professor Martin Green, OBE, formerly the government lead advisor on dementia, was a big supporter. He told us, "The Wayback enables people living with dementia and their family to connect and to share memories of major national events from the past. The Wayback is a powerful and useful resource for professionals and family alike. So what next? Not satisfied to have made a single film and encouraged by early results demonstrating the film at Care Home in England, we saw the potential to make a series of films which could be distributed nationally and internationally to help improve the lives of millions of people living with dementia, as well as their carers. While the ultimate goal of the medical community is to cure dementia, the objective of the vast majority of people caring for people with dementia is to make their lives more fulfilling, comfortable, and just increase their well-being. So we entered and we won the UK Challenge Dementia Prize, which is a grant of £100,000 backed by the Alzheimer's Society and Essex County Council. For us, it was a hugely pivotal moment, confirming our own belief in the idea with people who are on the front line of dementia care. The prize enabled us to make a second film, and this one was based around another hugely memorable national event, England winning the World Cup in 1966. At this early stage, recreating moments in time that are remembered by the majority of people mean our films can be enjoyed by a wider audience. But our plans going forward allow for us to make films particularly relevant to different communities, groups, and even other countries. The prize has also allowed us to create a bespoke app, which has enabled us now to find a route to market, which is crucial if we want to produce this wider spectrum of films.
You can spin your head the whole way around and you see the whole pub.
Oh, lovely.
And that's them celebrating after England's won.
Was that for the World Cup?
That was the World Cup, yeah, 1966.
In the middle of the street and everything, no cars, nothing. Maybe a few parks. Then just built the ball down and have a goal at each end.
We had two films finished and ready, and we had a finished app. The Wayback was ready to go to market. We set the business up as a subscription model, with viewers signing up to a minimum period of time and then receiving a cardboard viewer in the post. All they then need is access to a smartphone. Although the Wayback uses cutting-edge technology in the making of the films, the way the viewer accesses it is pretty lo-fi, just a cardboard viewer and a smartphone. Our mission statement is for as many people to see these films as possible. Maximum coverage rather than maximum revenue, as long as we can maintain the viability of the Wayback as a company. So, we were ready to go. We booked Colchester Football Stadium for that launch event. Jeff Hurst had endorsed the 1966 film and given us an interview, so we were going to show that at the launch event. Carers, care managers, activities managers from all over Essex and beyond had been invited. The sandwiches had been made. We were ready to launch the Wayback onto the market. And then COVID-19 hit. So during this period of lockdown, we have kept the Wayback accessible to anyone that wants to watch it for free. And through our social media channels, both in the advertising industry and the care industry, we have made sure people know that and posted out free cardboard viewing headsets to anyone who wanted them, in the hope of bringing a little bit of joy in these difficult times. Tech for good.
Yes, very much so. Going back in time.
Yeah, great memories.
Yeah.
Great memories. You never get rid of them.
Dementia is the cruelest of diseases. Not only does it rob you of the person you love, but it also erases connections between you. Conversations dry up as the person tries to piece together the pieces of their life, including you. Sometimes the only way to go forward is to go way back. And that is what we try to do with the Wayback. There are 850,000 people living with dementia in the UK at the moment, 20 million worldwide, and that's looking to double over the next 20 years as people live for longer.
Oh, yes, remember that, yeah.
Blimey. That brings about my old days.
One of the biggest problems for people living with dementia is their loss of self-esteem, their loss of connection, their loss of self-worth, which makes communication so, so hard. And that leads to depression and then potentially the need for medication. With the Wayback, we're really trying to keep people communicating, keep people involved and keep those conversations going. It was a gut instinct that took us here, fulfilling a need that people want, where creativity can meet technology and storytelling can help people. Our intention is to build a memory bank of films, but they don't always have to be national historic moments in time. They could be about the food, the photography, the fashion, the music, moments that generations will remember for decades to come. Every nation has its memories, and we have been approached by South Korea, by Russia, by Australia, by America to make memory bank films for their nation, to help people living with dementia in their communities, their loved ones and their carers. Our USP is that we're filmmakers, we tell stories, and we are absolutely thrilled that the Wayback is now a permanent member of the British Film Archive. Thank you very much for listening.